Introducing first, from Persia, and weighing in at 320 pounds, the Persian Prince of Pain, Mustafa Aziz.
Cradle March Madness rolling on here, and we are about to see two big monsters lock horns in the center of that ring.
Oh, no doubt about it. I hope the ring has been reinforced for this match. I don't know if this ring can contain these two guys.
Every time these guys get together, it is a huge collision.
I'm just glad I'm not a part of it. I think sitting out here with you is getting too close.
I have an escape route plan.
Good.
If you're nice to me, I might tell you what it is.
I'll just throw you in front of me and I'll take it. Mustafa Aziz. Dangerous, dangerous individual here in C4.
And his opponent, hailing from the South Pacific Island of Samoa, weighing 375 pounds, the Polynesian powerhouse, Nui Tofinga.
Oh, wow. They're going right at it.
Yeah. Excuse me for, you know, being a little biased in this match, but I hope Mustafa destroys Nui.
Well, I knew that was coming. Dave Adams had to get the hell out of Dodge there. Look at this.
Oh, he missed.
Oh, and a Beal. Who throws Mustafa Aziz with a Beal? Except, perhaps, Nui Tofinga.
Oh, Mustafa got out of Dodge. Tell you what, as far as Tofinga is concerned, he hasn't looked very good since I took him to the top.
What is the official doing here?
Oh, what a shot that was.
Flagpole to the hip. What is the official doing here?
Oh, what a shot that was. That's going to cause damage.
Absolutely.
And now Mustafa stays on him. He found a weak spot.
I'll tell you what. Well, you know, the good weak spots where you hit somebody with a flagpole, for God's sake.
Do what you got to do. Make him pay for leaving me. He hasn't been the champion since I managed him. Isn't that correct?
That is true.
Thank you very much. And the last time he was in that ring, he clotheslined me. Trust me, I don't forget things like that.
I know. You have aired many a grievance.
Thank you.
Thus far tonight, and I'm sure you're not done. Mustafa Aziz has a reason to complain right now.
That's an awful lot of poundage right there.
Samoan drop. Aziz able to pop that shoulder up at two, though.
At least we know one thing. That ring has been reinforced.
Maybe there's some girders under there or something. Aziz.
Shot block.
Yeah, swept that leg right out from under him.
Usually that cost you some money in the NFL, but not here. Stay on him. There you go. Oh, big splash.
A lot of man coming down there.
I think he might want to cover him right here. He certainly is. Tofinga kicking out.
I'll tell you what. Obviously, Tofinga, we know, giant wall of a man. But
yes.
Aziz still goes about three bills himself.
Yes, he does.
Oh. Right to the sternum there. Trying to drive the wind out of Nui Tofinga.
Man, might be close to the heart. Heard of a heart punch. It's like the heart stomp. What if he does break his sternum? He can't breathe.
I guess that's a good way to pin a man.
Uh-oh. He's not trying to fix a turnbuckle. Tofinga's in trouble.
The official is looking right at him. He could see him.
Oh!
So could Tofinga. Kick up under the chin.
Oh, diving headbutt.
Wow. Uh-oh. Oh, no.
Uh-oh. I know what's next.
I think we all do. Bad news for Aziz.
Get out of there. Oh! Cannonball. Wow, he got him.
Aziz.
Get out of there. Oh! Cannonball. Wow, he got him. Big victory for Nui Tofinga.
Here is your winner, the Polynesian powerhouse, Nui Tofinga.
Are you ready?
Introducing first, led to the ring by his manager, Diablo Rojo, representing the Puerto Rican Brothers, weighing 245 pounds and hailing out of Puerto Rico, G-Vader.
I don't know how to put this delicately.
Yeah.
But
be careful.
How many guys does Diablo Rojo already have? And how many of these guys represent the Puerto Rican Brothers? Is that a brand or?
I heard there's like 25 of them.
Are you kidding me?
I don't know.
That's a roster.
Well, yeah. He's got plenty at his disposal. That's what he told me.
Not a stable. A wrestling roster.
And his opponent approaching the ring from Fort Drum, New York, weighing 219 pounds, Sergeant R.J.
Should be an interesting matchup. We got a glimpse of G. Vader in a special interview with Xavier Cross just last month. However, I don't speak Spanish, so I couldn't inform you.
You don't know what he said.
Yes, I don't. I don't. However, G. Vader has.
Thank you for enlightening the crowd about nothing.
However, G. Vader, this is not his first appearance here, or even second in C4.
No, it isn't.
He is actually teamed with RJR before
at
Sportsfest.
And now they are opponents here.
Yeah, and apparently G. Vader, no sign of respect there for a former tag team partner.
I'd rather not talk about RJR and Sportsfest, if you don't mind. Bad memories.
Okay.
He kicked me in the throat.
Well, I mean, that would be a bad memory. Yes,
it would be.
I can't fault you there.
You're lucky I'm able to talk. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here with you right now.
And so far, it's been fairly pleasant.
Oh. For you.
Man, I throw you a bone. You're just swat it down. Just swat it down.
Side headlock there by RJR.
Oh!
Oh, just dumped him right on that ugly mug of his.
Now, I'll tell you what. While this is the first time in a long time the C4 Nation has seen G Vader in in-ring action.
Yes.
I, however, am familiar with the man's work, and I happen to know he does have a bit of a mean streak, and we're seeing that come into play already.
Nice leapfrog over the top. And another deep steamboat-like arm drag from RJR.
Say that five times fast.
Let me tell you something. RJR's got a little bit of a mean streak too, okay? I managed that guy at one particular point in time. I know he's got a mean streak in him. You just got to get it out of him, that's all. He's a very talented individual.
I think G. Vader was probably putting a bad mouth on him in the corner, if I know anything about Vader.
RJR slipped underneath the clothesline, came out with a double leg. Now it's the front face lock on G. Vader.
Vader able to get back to his feet.
He's got
to
go for something else here, though.
He doesn't have much of a size advantage,
oh, no.
But Vader is close to 260 pounds. RJR going a shade, maybe over 220, I want to guess.
What RJR is lacking right now is that killer instinct and his sight, because he can't see a damn thing right now.
Not what you want to happen when you're dealing, of course, with G. Vader, because Vader is capitalizing right now, going to work on the ribs of Sergeant RJR.
He's trying to fight back here, but he's got nothing behind those punches there, Salamander.
And here we go, Vader just stomping away.
Oh.
Standing on the man's throat.
Come on, ref. I like it, but the ref's got a job to do.
Absolutely. You got to separate these two.
See, you like what I did there? I actually was unbiased.
I know. It's crazy. Oh, look at this.
Crucifix.
He's got him.
This might be it. Oh.
He's still dealing with the problem with his eyes there.
Your sight doesn't return automatically. Oh, clothesline in the corner.
Sandwiched him.
And again. how G. Vader just staying on RJR here.
That's exactly what G. Vader does, though. That is exactly what this man does. As soon as you see even the slightest sign of weakness, he is all over it. I mean,
dumped him.
Obviously, we could say the same about any competitor. Oh, yeah. But, I mean, like I said, Vader, he's got that mean streak.
Look at this. Look at Rojo.
Getting in a couple shots here.
I can't fault him. He's not doing anything I wouldn't do. Look at him. Get his shots in.
Good Lord.
I think RJR said something bad about his sister.
I think RJR owes him money or something.
Boy, he's getting beat down, isn't he? Come on, RJR, fight back.
Good Lord.
I like that green, though.
Well, I mean, I do, too.
Nothing wrong with wearing green.
It's March. It's the time of my people. But
your people.
My people.
Ah.
Irish. You know, built the country.
I got it.
All that stuff.
I got it.
Yeah.
The only time you ever drink beer and claim that you're Irish.
I've always claimed I'm Irish.
I've never heard you say that.
Mostly because I am Irish. Let's focus, shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Happy St. Paddy's Day.
There we go.
Early. Anyway, G. Vader.
It's probably Easter right now.
Say what?
Never mind.
That's in April.
It's whenever I want it to be.
Look at this.
What?
RJR trying to get to his feet. I'm just going to pretend I didn't hear any of that. That didn't happen. RJR now. Shots to the midsection of G. Vader.
He's got to come back from this.
Oh!
1 foot drop kick. And a leg lariat, and that puts G. Vader down.
He caught him right up under the chin with that one.
Oh. Now he's feeling it. Big back body drop.
I'll tell you what. RJR, he's coming back.
This may not be a smart move.
Perhaps he feels it's an all or nothing situation here.
Oh!
He caught him.
Yes, he did.
Whoa.
We got problems here.
Well, the situation here.
Oh!
He caught him.
Yes, he did.
Whoa.
We got problems here.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's not 25, but there's at least five.
Oh, and the referee just got dumped. That's going to cost him some money. Trust me, I know.
This is ridiculous.
Well, RJR is going to win via disqualification, but... Oh!
Oh! Flatliner on the ropes.
Knee right to the face.
This is ridiculous.
Oh! They're trying to hurt this young man. Look out! Oh!
They might be trying to...
This young man. Look out!
They might be trying to retire this young man.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
We need security out here.
We need somebody out here.
We need some officials. Somebody's got to.
Actually, I'm kind of enjoying this beatdown.
Somebody's got to break this up.
Briefcase right into the gut.
Oh, and one to the back. Good Lord.
What is in that briefcase? Oh, boy.
Wait a minute. No. RC, let him go.
We got problems here.
Let him go.
Muscle and Mayhem are out here right now.
That's right.
This thing about to break down. We better get some officials out here or something. Look at Royal trying to get his boys back. They don't want none.
Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your craft.
You see, I will try 100 times to get up, and if I fail 100 times, if I fail and I give up, do you think that I'm going to get up? No.
You changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame. Like a big shadow.
What did you say to the kid? It ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get here and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward.
I'm motivated by fear.
All of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him picked, but the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
My deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. My deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure.
That's gonna make the difference between winning and losing. Between living and dying. In any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that itch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life in it, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that itch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face.
Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits. And not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
While the other guy's sleeping, I'm working. While the other guy's eating, I'm working.
Trust yourself, break some rules. Don't be afraid to fail. More than they say is perfect hell and give something back.
We'll be right back. store soon. Very handsome man on M&M's. Fans looking like they're getting under the skin of Adam Cole, the Panama City Playboy. All the way from London, England, gentleman Dave Rose. And it's been quite a time since we've seen him here in the States.
And his opponent,
As you mentioned earlier, that catch-as-catch-can strategy. I feel like Adam Cole, maybe the smaller man, but, you know, biggest isn't always the best.
True, but look at the sportsmanship already exhibited by the Englishman. Shook the referee's hand, going to shake his opponent's hand. What a sportsman.
They teach him that kind of stuff since birth over there.
And what disrespect by Adam Cole.
I think it's entertaining, getting these fans a little riled up.
Our fans don't pay to see people act like jerks. You know, there are children watching this. I don't want young fans to think that Adam Cole should be a role model for them.
I don't think he's doing anything obscene. I thought it was funny. I laughed.
You would, Winky. There's that catch-as-catch-can wrestling we were talking about. Nice duck under there by Cole to the wrist slot.
Now the superior strength. Oh, unbelievable.
Not much scientific there about that. It's a straight slap to the face. Cole looking for a sink of ground.
He doesn't want to get slapped himself. I think it's a brilliant maneuver.
Correct me if I'm wrong, and I am the commissioner here, but I don't remember timeouts being allowed in WXWC4.
Well, they should be. I mean, a guy could use a breather once in a while. He could use some form of a timeout. I think he should be allowed maybe one a match for about 10 seconds.
This isn't ballet, my friends. If you can't take the physicality, go there to sub.
Well, now Adam Cole in control, but not for long.
Wow. What a sequence to the top of the slide.
Wait a second. A second ago, you said this wasn't ballet, but that looked like ballet to me.
That's how graceful the gentleman is. Dave Rose with a nice overhand top wrist lock there. Cole trying to get out, gets to the ropes.
Hey, those are the rules. He's got to break the hold.
And I fully expect the gentleman to give a clean break, which he looks like he is.
Give him a timeout, ref. You can give him a couple seconds.
I'm going to have to say that someone needs to explain the rules to Mr. Cole. There are no timeouts in pro wrestling.
Well, you know what, Commissioner Maven Bentley? I'm going to actually personally get a petition signed for timeouts in WXWC4. I think it should be done. I think it's a movement that should be made, and I think I can get a lot of signatures.
I'm sure you could. I'm also sure I can take a timeout when I'm signing you guys' paychecks, maybe when I get to the W's and we
easy there, easy.
Nice go behind. Nice double leg trip. The gentleman with a front chancery. Referee in great position to make sure it's not a choke, and to see if Cole wants to submit. Cole out. Again, the gentleman. What a nice reversal into the fireman's carry. Back to that arm.
Now, do you see the smarts of Adam Cole, though, keeping that right shoulder off the mat?
That is
to not pin himself.
I have to agree. Cole, a very young wrestler, but doing a very smart veteran move, keeping that shoulder off the mat.
I feel like a lesser man would have tapped out already to that. But Adam Cole reversed.
The gentleman, thinking about it, beginning to get a little momentum, going in circles. You have momentum to fling Cole from the ring.
Cole, though, hanging on. Has to not hurt himself on that hard floor, as we mentioned earlier. Very smart maneuver by Cole.
And using that top rope as a weapon.
Making use of his surroundings. It's smart wrestling right there.
I call it a desperate move by a desperate man.
Call it what you will. It worked.
Cole control, using two stops to the back. Cole with a blatant choke. Look at that chokehold. Doing his whole body weight.
He broke the hold.
Again, I don't know what kind of kind of wrestling they teach them in Panama City. But here, we don't use chokeholds.
Well, the wrestling they teach them is standard wrestling. You get 5 seconds to break a hold if it's an illegal hold. He broke it in under 5 seconds.
Notice that, an illegal hold. I haven't seen a cheating move out of Mr. Rose yet. Mr. Rose is a true gentleman. He called with the closed fist, ignoring the referee's dictates.
Well, I'm sure if the push came to shove, Mr. Dave Rose wouldn't be so gentlemanly.
Nice forearm shiver by the Englishman.
Oh, where's the gentleman there? Hit him while he's in the corner.
European. Second European.
Oh, I get it, because he's from Europe.
Yes, yes. European uppercut.
I felt like the ring moved on that.
That's the power of Dave Rose. Nice leg, Larry, from the top by Cole, though.
That's that quickness proving to be a factor here in this matchup.
Cover. One, two. And again, you're not going to pin a veteran like Dave Rose while either hooking a leg or putting the full body weight across the plank of those shoulders.
Going for it again. Trying to catch him off guard. He barely got his shoulders up for that two count.
Dave Rose just too powerful and not worn down enough yet by the young playboy from Panama City. Now again, this is what I understand about these young wrestlers. He's wasting time. Assaulting our fans instead of going after his man, Dave Rose.
I just think he knows where he's at. I think he knows what he's doing. He thinks he's got him wrapped up, and I think he's right.
To the top rope, high rent district.
Mike Cross Body, oh my God, he caught him.
What power out of gentleman Dave Rose. And a running power slam.
Did he get all of it?
Look at that armor. Look at that.
I've never seen anything like it.
The rings of Rose. And the match is over.
Gentlemen,
by
the winner of this match, gentlemen, Dave Rose.
Gentlemen, This is Carlito, and if you want to become a professional wrestler and learn how to train the correct way, then there's no better place to go than the Wild Samoan Training Center. And that, my friends, that's cool.
Wild Samoan Training Center
at WXW C4 headquarters,
located at 309 East Hamilton Street, Allentown, Pennsylvania 18109. The Wild Samoan Training Center has been a staple in pro wrestling for many decades and has produced some of the best athletes and wrestlers to grace the ranks of sports entertainment. Now with their own brand, WXW C4's Blast TV, on the rise. Talent from all over has been clamoring to be a part of the new explosive era. WXW C4 Blast TV, on Service Electric Cable, Friday, 10 p.m., Channel 50, and on Blue Ridge Cable, Saturday, 1 p.m., Channel 13. For any questions, or even to buy a ticket to one of WXW C4's explosive shows, head over to the WXW C4 store at www.wxwc4.com. One more time, that's www.wxwc4.com.
I'm a warrior, Superman, Hulk. I'm a prodigy taking over the game. Even though a lot of people will doubt me because of fame. Now you know I'm a legend that people would know my name. I'm a warrior, Superman heart. Call me Roman Reigns. Take them on a journey where they can notice a warrior. Sacrifice for soldiers, we on styles victorious. I'm like the Royal Rumble, I'm winning, taking the gold. Cause in life, you should know, it's always about control. And my soul got the tribal that is tatted on my arm. Got the motivate for justice, so better ring the alarm. Just respond, we are on something that you have never seen. Got the Uso by my arm, if you want the triple team. Nothing you have ever seen, something you can never be. Heart of being great, I want it all while I'm living dreams. The world is mine and my future is always brighter. Taking it all by storm to the moment that I retire. Never will I expire, fire up the igniters. The rain is just beginning and blasting up through the fires. The world is now my storm and the challenges will remain off the chain. But the warrior, call your boy Roman Reigns. Even though I'm a prodigy taking over the game. Even though a lot of people will Roman doubt me Reigns. Because of fame. Now you know I'm a legend that people would know MTL, my name. I'm MTL. A warrior, Superman heart. Call me Roman
gotta get
Reigns.
Drums
even though I'm a prodigy taking over the game. Yeah. Even though a lot of people would doubt me because of fame. Jesus. Now you know I'm a legend that Swag people right. would know my name. I'm
Davey
a warrior,
Jones.
Superman heart. Call me Roman Reigns. Even though I'm a prodigy taking over Woo. The game. Even though a lot of people would doubt me because of fame. Now you know I'm a legend that people would know my name. I'm
warrior,
a warrior,
baby.
If you want to become a professional wrestler and learn how to train the correct way, then there's no better place to go than the Wild Samoan Training Center.
Okay, so we drowned the fire,
yep.
Stirred it,
mm-hmm.
Drowned it again,
mm-hmm.
And now just feel if it's cold.
Yeah.
Cool.
Smokey just gave me a bear hug.
I know. I already posted it.
Crazy as if they didn't already start out that way. But welcome, of course, to WXW C4 Blast TV. Salamander Jones joined, of course, by Mr. Sean Cradle.
That's how you're going to introduce me?
Mr. Sean Cradle, the manager of champions.
And? The greatest manager in the history of WXW
C4. Look, if you're going to keep adding to your resume, you got to have it right here in front of me for notes.
Greatest commentator ever, too.
This guy.
Stick with
and
me, kid.
Their opponents,
from the streets of South Philly, at a combined weight of 401 pounds, the gent Jimmy Conway, the line Luca Brasi, together they form SPF, South Philly.
You know, sometimes I wonder if Dave Adams sees spots when he draws it out like that. That man's got a set of lungs on him.
I just wonder what happens when he gets laryngitis.
Probably not pretty. And I don't think this matchup's going to be very pretty either. South Philly's finest, very fired up, as they are every time they appear.
Yes, they are.
In front of the C4 Nation, because these guys are guys that have been desperately trying to get their hands on the WXWC4 tag team titles.
That's correct.
And they're always just within reach. Just within reach.
But somehow it keeps slipping through their fingers, doesn't it?
I only think it's a matter of time. But this young team that they're facing here tonight, Sudden Impact.
Yes.
The last time they appeared here at Mountainville Memorial Hall, actually took on the current WXWC4 champions, Muscle Mayhem, Solo, and Napalm Bomb, two gentlemen I'm sure you're very familiar with as well.
I am very familiar with them.
And I'll tell you what, Sudden Impact, they gave up a lot of size to Muscle Mayhem, but these young guys, and they are young, only been teamed together for about a year, out of Washington, D.C., very cocky, very arrogant, very sure of themselves.
I like them.
I'm sure you do.
Sounds good to me already. In fact, I'm out here scouting talent here tonight. Who knows? Maybe I'll sign these guys, and they can be a part of the new Cradle Collective. What do you think?
I suspected as much when you came and sat down next to me.
Well, somebody's got to make you look good.
And we got an opening bell here. Looks like the line, Luca Brasi, starting things off against L.I. Green.
This should be good. The two speedsters of the teams.
Brasi there offered his hand, Green having none of it. And now Green coming up with a side headlock here, really wrenching it in.
Yes, he is.
Young man, not the largest competitor in the ring, but in great physical condition. But Brasi was able to shuck him off and then comes up with that big chop to the chest.
Never doubt the heart in a fight of anybody there. Oh.
You said this was going to be fast. It definitely is.
Look at them both jockeying for position here.
Wait a minute. Brasi with a counter, man, and it comes up.
Why do these people like SPF? Can you tell me that?
They're a great team. They come out. They love being here. They love the C4 fans. They're very exciting to watch. Unique tandem offense. Any of that ring a bell? Green able to duck the Irish whip, but not those chops.
Come on.
Oh!
Isn't there a five count referee? Shouldn't you be using it?
Double count. Elbow there, got the two count.
That count looked a little fast to me.
Oh,
come on, ref, get in there! That's illegal, referee, last time I checked.
That is overwhelmingly unpleasant.
Do you want me to go in there and referee this match, too?
You're fine here. You're fine here. Settle down. Maybe have a Xanax or something.
You can tell I'm a little angry.
I can.
I just came back from suspension.
Oh, snap suplex.
I didn't appreciate the vacation.
Oh, and Brasi with a pair of knees. Green kicks out at two.
Green needs to get out and make that tag.
Yes, he does.
Or at least break the eyes or something.
Well, you know, whatever works, right?
Hey, when if you can't lose if you must, but always cheat.
Green now makes the tag to Rick Powers.
I love how these people are chanting, "You can't wrestle to a wrestler."
It's interesting. I never quite understood the dynamic myself. Ooh.
You're not going to out-muscle Rick Powers.
It's in his name.
And then this is a mistake. A huge mistake by Brasi.
Rossio able to escape.
Look at him, just throw him down.
Look at this. Powers just keeps pushing him off. Rossi just keeps attacking and swinging wildly.
Oh,
look at that.
He finally knocked him down with that drop kick, though.
Powers tried to launch him into the air. Brazzi was able to come up with that kick. Powers to the outside now, calling for a timeout.
There you go.
Brazzi not hearing it.
Oh! That was beautiful. Beautiful. He set him up for that kick on the outside.
I got to give it to you. That was incredible teamwork there, especially from such a young team.
I tell you what, they look impressive. There's a cover. Oh, didn't hook the leg in time, Salamander. It might have cost him.
Absolutely not. Thought about it that last second, but at that point it was too late. Now just trying to basically ground and pound Luca Brasi. Not a bad strategy. No. You want to keep the smaller man down.
Watch out for that cheater Conway.
Dragging him into the wrong part of town. Legal. And now Green stomping away.
Legal tag.
Absolutely.
And they're cutting the ring in half. Outstanding tag team wrestling.
Absolutely.
It's almost like if I was in their corner.
Well, technically where we're sitting, you are kind of in their corner.
Well, technically, yes. Yeah. Maybe they can hear me. They can hear me. I would go for a suplex. There you go. How about that?
Wow.
Boy.
It's almost like you saw him setting up for a suplex.
I didn't see it at all. I don't know what you're talking about.
What's this big monitor next to us?
Of course, that cheater Conway come in to break it up. And a smart move by Powers to drag Brazzi into his own corner.
Brazzi's been in there a long time.
Yes, he has.
Green and Powers have been keeping each other fresh.
Oh, what a shot.
Pointed the elbow right to the sternum, and it got the two count.
Now see, this is where ego gets in the way there, Salamander. If he had tagged his partner in, quick tags, he wouldn't be in the position that he's in right now.
Brazzi hasn't had the opportunity. Every time he mounts some offense, sudden impact has been just that, impactful, and shut him down before he could make the tag to Conway.
Oh, referee out of position. Oh, come on. That was a three count right there. And if the referee was in position, this match would be over.
Oh, a Powers shoving Conway.
That's going to bring Conway
off the apron.
In.
Smart draws the official.
Yep, look at this double team.
Stomping away.
Conway is doing more damage to Brazzi than sudden impact is right
and
now.
And if Brazzi was a bunch of grapes, we'd have wine right now.
Oh. I'm not giving you credit for that. That was not good.
Stop it. Oh. Green snapping him over.
Oh!
Drop kick to the mush.
Right in the face. Oh, he didn't hook a leg, though.
Absolutely not. But, again, this is the cockiness. This is the arrogance of this team, sudden impact.
Well, sometimes, you know, I can understand it. But in a match like this, you got to hook the leg. Hook the tights, hook the ropes, hook something.
Pull his hair.
Doesn't have any
rip out his eyelashes, whatever.
Whatever's necessary.
Pull his beard.
Pay it for having one.
Powers now in off the tag.
You don't see anybody touching Bo Nakoda's beard ever, do you?
I think I lovingly see you to apply conditioner every once in a while.
You know what?
I could be mistaken. Could have been a trick of the light.
You're funny.
Oh! Wow. No tricks there.
Not at all.
Cover now.
Wow, that was close. Beautiful half Nelson right in the pin. And somehow Brazzi kicked out. I can't believe it.
And you could see there from that angle in the background, you could see Conway. He is just, he's like a caged tiger on the ring apron. Just dying for a tag.
Slapping him around might be a mistake. You got Brazzi on the ropes, knock him out. This might be where the inexperience comes into play.
Powers is measuring his shots, though.
That was a good right hand.
Absolutely.
Almost knocked them on the floor. These people don't like sudden impact, do they?
They haven't really done much to cultivate an air of likability, if you will.
See that? Measured him, that shot right in the kidney.
Yeah, this Rick Powers, he likes to take his time. He's you know, sometimes you see a young man, they get really excited in there, and they rush things. He's really taking his time here.
Look how much time he's holding him up. There was a tag game, too. He held him up for like 10 seconds. Senton. Oh!
Green now going for the cover. Trying to roll him over. Shoots a hip.
Oh, come on. Get Conway out of there.
Conway had enough time to see what was going down.
That should be a disqualification.
Everybody arguing here. Might have given Brazzi a couple seconds there.
No.
I don't know if that's enough with the beating he's taken so far. Yeah, he's limp. Look at this.
Yeah, Luka's in big, big trouble.
I don't think he knows where he is.
No, he's been in the ring for almost 10 minutes now. How much punishment can he take?
Oh! Step up Benzaguri. Takes down Green.
And will that give him the time he needs to go over there and make that tag to Conway? Conway itching to get in there.
Absolutely. Green clutching the side of his head. That really rung his bell there. But look at this.
I can't do it. Beautiful front face lock preventing him from making that tag.
But it looks like he may have pulled him to his feet.
Oh.
Oh, what a forearm. Are you kidding me?
I haven't seen a team cut off the ring like this in a long time. Oh, but he made a mistake.
Brazzi was able to make the tag, and now Conway coming in. The gent.
Didn't knock him down, though. That knocked him down.
He sure did. Leg up under the chin.
Oh.
Oh, atomic drop.
Or the reverse kind. Oh, wow. Brazzi got cut off.
I believe they were going for the drive-by there.
He's not
sudden
ready
impact,
to get back
saw it coming.
Oh, no!
Oh.
He closed on his own partner!
Yes, he did.
Oh! He's not
sudden
ready
impact,
to get back
saw
in
it coming.
Oh, no!
Oh.
He closed on his own partner!
Yes, he did.
Oh! He had the tights or something.
Here are your winners! The Gent Jimmy Conway and the line of Luka Brazzi, South Philly's finest.
I can't believe FBF took it.